Ladies and gentlemen, participants of this meeting, dear guests, I'm happy to welcome you here in the Republic of Tatarstan. Last year in Moscow, the first meeting of this group took place. It was the first meeting in its new setup, in its new composition. And now we are having our second meeting in this composition here in Kazan, in the capital of Tatarstan. Please allow me to thank the Russian Foreign Ministry and the Presidential Administration for sponsoring this meeting, as well as the Islamic Bank and the Islamic Development Corporation for supporting this initiative. I would also like to thank the representatives of foreign countries and of Russia's regions who take part in this group. Its meetings unite experts, politicians, and decision makers from many countries in order to strengthen the relations between Russia and the Muslim world, exchange opinions and best practices, as well as together develop solutions and approaches to the various challenges facing Russia and Muslim countries. Russia is a multi-ethnic country, which is home to over 20 million Muslims. An absolute majority of them are indigenous here in Russia. As the Russian state was being formed, it accepted new territories and their population, which represented different ethnic groups with different languages and different cultures. Our unity was forged in a difficult and somewhat sometimes in a difficult manner, but we have come to an identity where Russian statehood is the basis of our joint identity. And Tatarstan is one of the best examples. It is one of Russia's most successful and dynamic regions. And one of the reasons for that is harmonious inter-ethnic relations here among the different communities that live in this republic and have lived in this region for centuries, side by side. A decisive factor in the peaceful coexistence is played by the mutual respect and the constructive attitudes of Orthodox Christian and Muslim religious organizations. The Kazan Kremlin accommodates both a Muslim mosque and an Orthodox cathedral. The Orthodox Sviarsk town and the ancient Muslim city of Bulgar are being restored at the same time, simultaneously. Just recently, we lay a cornerstone for the construction of the Bulgar Spiritual Academy, and soon we will lay a cornerstone for building a church of the Kazan icon of the Virgin Mary. This principle of peaceful coexistence relates not only to Russia's domestic policies, but also its international foreign policies. We seek friendship and cooperation with Muslim countries, regarding them as one of the important pillars of the modern day world. The Russian President, Mr. Vladimir Putin, attributes great attention to cooperation with Muslim countries. It was his initiative that in 2005, Malaysia and Russia became observers in the Islamic Development Organization, in the Islamic Cooperation Organization. In his welcome address at the opening of a cathedral mosque in Moscow, President Putin stressed the importance of preserving inter-religious and inter-community peace and coexistence is paramount, saying that it is an important contribution to combating religious extremism and nationalism. President Putin also highly stressed Russia's tradition of enlightened Islam and paid his tributes to it. Today, the international community is facing a global threat where terrorism and extremism are increasingly popular and gaining new supporters. it is important to prevent them and debase their dangerous ideas. That can only be done in cooperation with the majority of the Muslim world that strongly defy terrorism and reject terrorism. Russia has contributed a lot of efforts to that, particularly within the framework of this strategic vision group. It was under its auspices that a meeting of prominent representatives of the Muslim world was held. You will be able to get to know its documents during our meeting. We also pay special attention to economic cooperation. Last week, Kazan hosted the International Economic Summit of Russia and the Islamic World, the so-called Kazan Summit. There is also a tradition of a summer camp of the Organization of Islamic Cooperation, a young diplomats conference of the Islamic Cooperation Organization, and also a business forum of the Islamic Cooperation Organization. Our republic is trying to become the point of entry for Muslim countries in their economic cooperation with Russia. Tatarstan is one of Russia's most dynamic and economically developed regions. Last year, our republic rated number one in the all-Russian investment climate rating. We pay special attention to innovative developments. Our republic is home to Russia's leading special economic development zones, and I'm head of the Economic Association of Russia's Regions. And I would like to welcome investors from your countries to work with Tatarstan's production enterprises and innovation platforms and investment platform. We really are very hopeful about the upcoming Islamic Academy in Bulgar, sponsored and patronized by our former president, Mr. Shaimiev. Its opening will contribute to the development and promotion of enlightened Islam in Tatarstan. Also, the translation of the works of various thinkers and writers from Islamic countries is also carried out in Tatarstan. We have recently translated the works of the Lebanese publicist and writer Halaji on Russia and President Putin. There is also a documentary studio that works here, and we recently produced a video documentary on the Emir of Kuwait. Starting from the beginning of the activities of the strategic vision groups, we've already held over 25 meetings of various formats, including roundtables, conferences, and festivals, including two international forums of journalists. Recent forum closed with a letter, with an address calling for the closing of channels and networks that spread and support terrorism. We also instituted and established an award, a Yevgeny Primakov Award. Earlier, we carried out a contest among Russians for the best contribution in spreading knowledge about the true Islam, in supporting and fostering mutual understanding among the various ethnic communities in Russia. We received over 100 applications and works, and 10 of them were marked with special diplomas. Ladies and gentlemen, each of us can contribute and make a sound contribution to promoting inter-ethnic dialogue and a partnership of civilizations. I wish you a substantive and fruitful discussion, and I wish you success in your deliberations. And once again, I would like to thank you for your attention and for your willingness to come to the city and take part in our meeting. Thank you very much.